You may be seated. Now, I would like to introduce our surprise guest speaker for this spring Higaon service. Our surprise guest speaker is, as you all know and you've seen him come in, Reverend Ishikawa, and he is from the Koloa Jodo Mission. Hey, Reverend Ishikawa.
First of all, thank you very much for inviting me to this special service. Thank you, Majima-sensei. Majima-sensei is very generous and thoughtful and kind, and I really appreciate for the invitation. Because I'm here to share the Buddhist teaching with you for the purpose of happiness of more people. So, in this sense, Sensei gave me the great happiness. Sensei made me happy today. So I'm truly appreciate Sensei for this great opportunity. And because I asked Sensei to keep secret about guest speaker, it's because I want to explain about surprise. And I have also surprised to Sensei. Because Sensei made me happy, I made a bed yesterday. Thank you so much. And also, because I asked surprise guests, probably you imagine what kind of speaker coming. Is it, you know, celebrity coming? Or, you know, who can be a guest speaker? And depending on your imagination, you may be glad to see me, or you may be disappointed. Oh, I imagine, you know, somebody very famous coming to the speaker. Or you don't expect, oh, that's okay, maybe. So it depends on the imagination or expectation. You may be glad, you may be happy, or you may be disappointed. And this expectation is very important. And Buddhism teaches us expectation make law as possible. By keeping the expectation lowest, the worst, everything can be blessing. This is a great teaching of Buddhism. So Buddhism teaches that life is suffering, not life is pleasure. Because of the low expectation. By realizing life is suffering, life is the worst, then what happens? Anything can be better. You know the worst. Actually, it's very hard to imagine the worst situation. Worst is the worst. There is no more worse. The worst. It's very hard to imagine. But if we can imagine the worst situation, anything can be blessed. So the other day, my camera was broken. You know, but as compared to the worst, this is very good, better. And the other day, I had a traffic accident. Somebody hit the car from the van. But as compared to the worst, this is better. And actually, I'm healthy, you know. So this is the great teaching. Life is very suffering. Realize by understanding truly and imagination of the worst, any moment can be a great moment of blessing. So that I wanted to explain. Also, the meaning of surprise can be divided in two parts. That is sa and prize. Sa and prize. That is the division of the word surprise. And sa means above or up. And prize is actually Latin originating word is to prehend. Prehender is actually to get. But this is the same word of prize or prison or pray or praise. Same root. So my understanding of surprise is it's a prize from the above. It's prize from the above. That is surprise. And because of the prize from the above, all of a sudden came then with surprise. That is the meaning of surprise. Then why we divide is in Japanese we call wakaru or wakarimasu in Japanese. Wakaru or wakarimasu in Japanese. And wakaru, wakarimasu is translated into understand in English. Okay, so wakaru or wakarimasu is same as understand. But wakaru or wakarimasu literally means to divide. So what is understanding in Japanese is to divide. If you can divide a small unit, small element, then we understand more about understanding. So for example, the English word understand, we can divide under and stand. Under the stand. Under the stand is actually, I'm here at the Kappa Hongwaju Mission. I stand and understand. So the best way to understand is standing here. This is a very concept of English. If you want to know about Japan, you go to Japan and you stand. That is a concept, English concept of understand. But Japanese concept of understand is to divide. By dividing the elements, surprise, understand, we know better of the world. That is the concept of understanding. So today, I'd like to understand the meaning of ohigan. The word of the ohigan is because ohigan is a translation of perfection or the supreme enlightenment. And there are some synonyms, the same word of supreme in English. For example, synonym of supreme is best, greatest, top, foremost, leading, preeminent, premier, prime, first, chief, supreme, par excellence, second to none. There are many expressions, and that all means top, the highest, supreme. So by understanding more of the synonyms, the same meaning, we know more about the very concept of the supreme. What is supreme? And what is interesting is the Chinese characters, how they express the supreme, the concept of supreme, the concept of the best is very interesting because cultures between Japan and English so different. So to understand what Japanese words to mean supreme is a meaning. So now I want to see supreme, ichiban, number one, the number one. That is the Japanese Ichiban, is number one. And next Japanese word to mean supreme is Saiko. Saiko. Kappa Honganji Saiko. Sai is the greatest. And Ko means the highest. So Saiko, the word Saiko, if we divide Sai and Ko, we understand the greatest and highest. That is Saiko. And next, Saijo. Saijo, Sai is the greatest. And Jo is the most above. The most above. This is another expression of the best. Saijo. We can say Saijo. Like today, I made sushi and cake. And this is Saijo. There is the most above delicious food. And there is a very interesting saying in Japanese. Buta mo odateria kimi noboru. Do you know the meaning? Buta mo odateria kimi noboru. English translation is, if pig are praised, if pig is praised, pig can climb up the tree. That is the meaning. So if, you know, even the pig, oh, you have a nice color, you're such a nice pig. Oh, you know, you're nice fat. Oh, what a beautiful pig. Then pig are so happy. Pig is very happy, and pig can climb up the tree. That is the meaning. So today is, I'm very same feeling. Oh, sensei, cake so good. Sensei, oh, the talk is so good. And I'm kind of praised. And so I'm very happy. I became very happy. So I made sushi this morning. So anyway, this is the Saijo is another expression of suffering. The most above, that is Saijo. And there are more expressions. That is Mujo. This is very interesting. Mujo. Mu is none or no, mu. And Jo is above. There is no above. That is a literal translation. There is no above. So no above means same as the highest. So this is Mujo is actually often used in the Buddhist scriptures. So I actually quote Kaikyoge when before reading the sutra, we always read, I mean, Jodo should read, Mujo Jinjin Ningyoko is a supreme and profound and wondrous dharma. So Mujo is very popular word to mean supreme, non-abhat. And next is also Muni. Muni is actually English translation, there is second to none. There is no second. Second to none is Muni, is also means number one. And also there is a word Muhi. Muhi is, Mu is none, and He is comparison. You cannot compare. No comparable. That is Muhi. That you cannot compare means that is the best. There is no comparison, is the best. So this is another interesting in expression. And Chinese expression, Muso. Muso, so means two. So this is another expression of second to none. Second to none means the best. And next is Tenka Ichi. Tenka Ichi is a, Tenka is a, under the heaven. Under the heaven, number one. Number one, under the heaven. That is Tenka Ichi. In Honolulu, there is a ramen shop called Tenka Ichi. Tenka Ichi. You know, that's one of my best ramen in Honolulu. That is Tenka Ichi. Chinese people like the phrase, Tenka Ichi. Number one, under the heaven. And this number one under the heaven means that heaven is number one, actually. Heaven is number one. And except heaven, number one under the heaven. So this is very deep. So to respect heaven first. And then number one in the under the heaven. And another expression is shikō. Shikō is a shi is a to reach. So to reach the high place. To reach the high place is also another expression of supreme. And shijō is same. To reach the top. To reach the top is expression of supreme or best. And last, kyūkyoku. Kyūkyoku is kyū, is actually to investigate or to study. And kyoku is the ultimate pole. So to investigate the utmost, ultimate place, that is the number one, another expression of kyūkyoku. So these are very popular words. To me, supreme, Ichiban, Saiko, Saisho, Mujo, Uni, Muhi, Muso, Tenkai, Chishiko, Kyūkyoku. And actually, today is Ohigan service, and the word Higan is also mean number one. And Chinese people, how they thought about the translation, what is a good word to mean the perfection? The supreme word. So they imagine that in order to reach the supreme state or supreme word, there must be hardship of river, you know, great river, huge river, in order to reach the supreme state. And so Chinese translate the other shore, not this shore, other shore of the river. The other shore of the river is a supreme state or a supreme world. That is Higan in Chinese characters. So Higan, what is Higan? Is the word parameter. Or param is actually perfection. And paramita is to reach the other shore. So there was an explanation in the booklet. To reach the other shore. To reach the other shore is paramita. And that is actually another expression, or another Chinese word to mean the supreme or perfection. And Buddhism teaches how we can get close to the other shore, how we can reach the world of enlightenment. And there are many ways, and we respect all Buddhist teachings. But especially our teaching is very great, because we can say Namu Amida, Namu Amida. And if you believe, you make it. You make it. What a great thing that we just say Namu Amida. Or if you believe, you don't need to say Namu Amida. But Namu Amida is a very easy word. We can get close the hardship of the life to reach the ultimate world. So thank you very much. Really appreciate Amida Buddha's blessing. Thank you very much. And of course, for the purpose of your development or improvement, you can enjoy many other teachings, such as meditation, chanting different sutras, you know, listening as a priest, you know. That is all we can enjoy for the purpose of development. But to get close to the other shore of Amida Buddha land, we just believe in Namu Amida. That is great. So Thank you. I'm really appreciate for this opportunity to share the message. Majima先生, thank you very much. ありがとうございます。